Hello. Today, I'm going to show you how to use patterns and exclusion filters to improve log utilization. This is a tip I've shown customers to help them understand how patterns work, where they can make changes so logs are easier to work with and potentially even reduce costs. Later, I'm going to show you one way to stay ahead of unexpected log volume spikes. Without further delay, let's begin here on the Logs Explorer. Well, right away, I can show you that I have in my demo environment over 14.4 million logs from the past hour. So what I'm going to do here is click this Patterns button. And what we're going to see is that I have over 450,000 logs coming in from my web store using this */* pattern that are informational and they're probably not bringing me too much value. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click into this example and I'm going to click this Add Exclusion Filter button. What this is going to allow me to do is create an exclusion filter. My exclusion filter name here that I've already added is Tips, and this query is pre-populated because I hit the Add Exclusion Query button on the previous screen. It's already set to exclude 100% of all of these logs. What that means is these logs will not be indexed for long-term searching in Datadog. They will exist only in this live tail. You can still see them in the live tail in case you need to do any troubleshooting on them. So what I'm going to do is show you how I can prove that this filter has worked. So I'm going to go straight into the Logs Explorer where I can use this button here to verify. Here we can see a query, and you can see in the past 15 minutes, there's no logs based upon the query that we just have. I can now say, go to the past 15 minutes and boom, I have those logs again. So that is one way that you can reduce log volumes from some noisy logs, such as informational logs, as we see here, maybe a health check or something like that. Now I'll show you how to stay ahead of unexpected increases in log volume by setting up an alert for ingestion spikes. Be sure to use a threshold that works for your environment so you're alerted only when log volume increases in a meaningful way. Your log volumes are going to vary, and I'm using a threshold just to highlight from my demo environment what an alert state looks like and what a warning state looks like. We can see this measured here in this graph where I have an alert state of 1.44 gigabytes for this product recommendation service. You can see the thresholds that I set for warnings and alerts. I've defined a metric to use for this alert here. It is datadog.estimated_usage.logs.ingested_bytes. And I'm summarizing that by service. That's how I was able to see before that my product recommendation service is sending a whole lot of logs over the past 5 minutes. So one thing you want to do is set an alert condition that will warn you when your metric goes above a value above a specific amount for any given service. Here, my alert threshold is 1 gigabyte, and my warning threshold is about 800 megabytes. Again, I'm setting these numbers to highlight what an alert could be within my demo environment. I've gone ahead and named my alert Log Volume is Rising. I set the first portion here to be is warning with some text in the between these two curly braces. This is going to be the message that we'll send along with which specific service is sending a high volume of logs based on the warning criteria. The data between is alert is the information that will be sent to you when it crosses the alert threshold. One thing you need to do is be sure that you set something like a Slack notifier, an email notifier to your alerts to make sure that the correct people are notified. And that's how you can use patterns and exclusion filters to improve log utilization. I've also showed how you can set up an alert to stay ahead of unexpected log volume increases. Thank you for watching. Check out the video description for more resources and how to learn more.